American Pie was, of course, his poetic ode to the 60s, but another of Don McLean's great songs was called Vincent, a tribute to the works and the life of artist Vincent van Gogh. Ladies and gentlemen, Don McLean.
Starry, starry night, paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills, sketch the trees and the daffodils, catch the breeze and the winter chills in colors on the snowy linen land. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, how you suffered for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now. Starry, starry night, flaming flowers that brightly blaze, swirling clouds in violet haze reflect in Vincent's eyes of china blue, colors changing hue. Morning fields of amber grain, weathered faces lined in pain, are soothed beneath the artist's loving hand. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now, for they could not love you, but still your love was true. And when no hope was left in sight on that starry, starry night, you took your life as lovers often do. But I could have told you, Vincent, this world was never meant for one as beautiful as you. Starry, starry night, portraits hung in empty halls, frameless heads on nameless walls, with eyes that watch this world and can't forget, like the strangers that you've met. The ragged men in ragged clothes, a silver thorn, a bloody rose, lie crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never
will. I really love your music. It's poetic, it's beautiful, it says a lot about a period that's important in my life, American Pie especially, Vincent also. But American Pie was the biggest song that you ever had. It was so big, as you said in the...
It was plenty big.
It was plenty big. I mean, gold and more gold, and I'm sure you were asked to play it every day of your life. How do you feel about it now, looking back on it?
Well, I'm proud of it, and I mean that, but I'm... Also, like I said, it's a song that I wrote 2 years ago, and it's 2 years of living has gone down since then. But, you know, as a performer, you have to get used to singing things. I sing And I Love You So, which I wrote 7 years ago. That became a hit last year, so everybody was interested in my singing that song, so I started singing it again. Vincent is 3 years old. You just have to find new meanings in the material, otherwise you'll bore yourself to tears. And that's what happens. Every night something creeps up on me, and I find a little nuance or a little corner of the song that I've never ventured into before, and so it keeps my interest. The probing and the whole cult that grew up around the song, I think, is sort of interesting, but it really bore no relationship to my life and began to sort of bore me after a while.
In literature, especially when an author, his first book is autobiographical, they say the general experience is a difficult time writing the second novel.
Well, it's because, you know, you put 20 years of living into some things, and then you got 6 months to come up with a sequel.
Do you think, has that been your experience?
Well, no, because I never expected to be successful, really. You know, American Pie was 9 minutes long. I knew that there are certain rules you don't break about top 40 radio, and one of them is that nothing is over 3.5 minutes. Theory being that the people aren't smart enough to remember anything that's too much longer than that, which is a lot of... But, you know, got to keep something simple. Everybody can whistle. That's their theory, you know. I gave them something they could whistle, but it was 9 minutes long, so...
Are you under great pressure to come up with another American Pie? Or Vincent, or...
No, I'm not, because... music for me is self-expression, and I think the first two albums I made, Tapestry and American Pie, were introspective to a degree, but I had my finger on the pulse of what was going on. After American Pie, my life was destroyed, and my value systems were thrown around in a funny kind of way.
Because, by superstardom?
Yeah. I really, you know, it was like being in a room by yourself and opening a door and having 8 million people there. That's the feeling that I have in trying to relate how it felt, you know. All of a sudden, up, here's a party for 8 million people. So, up, close the door. So the Don McLean record, which followed that, was really the most introspective thing I have ever done. It was just an effort to talk about the insanity that was encroaching in on me and how I felt more and more detached from reality. Then I stopped writing altogether. Quit it. I figured that, well, if the audience, you know, I can't explain to them any better than I have on this record. It's, other than going out and saying, look, I just don't want to write anymore for a while. And then a friend of mine came along named Frank Wakefield, who's a crazy guy, plays the mandolin. He's a real genius. And he said, you know, we got to make an album together, just happy songs that mean something to you, because you got to get your spark back. And I, you know, I didn't know what to do. He just started playing that mandolin. I started feeling good again, and then I decided the best thing for me to do is quit doing gigs for a while and just start to build life all over again so that songs would come out. And around October of last year, I finished a European tour, and I decided I'd come home and not go away for a while. And I just started, all of a sudden, everything began to slow down, and I began to see the reality of my situation and how much it had changed and how quickly it had changed from the days when each little song that I wrote was a major thing. Each little lick that I learned on the guitar was invaluable to me. And once again, things began to have that value. And now the songs started flowing.
Okay, we'll listen to one of your new songs when we come back in just 1 minute, okay? Homeless Brother. Singing the title song from his album to be released in September, Homeless Brother, here's Don McLean.
I was walking by the graveyard late last Friday night. I heard somebody yelling, it sounded like a fight. It was just a drunken hobo dancing circles in the night, pouring whiskey on the headstones in the blue moonlight. So often have I wondered where these homeless brothers go, down in some hidden valley where their sorrows cannot show, where the police cannot find find them where the wanted man can go. There's freedom when you're walking, even though you're walking slow. Smash your bottle on the gravestone and live while you can. That homeless brother is my friend. It's hard to be a pack rat, it's hard to be a bull, but living so much harder where the heartless people go. Somewhere the dogs are barking and the children seem to know that Jesus on the highway was a lost hobo. And they hear the holy silence of the temples in the hill, and they see the ragged tatters as another kind of frill. And they envy him the sunshine and they pity him the chill. They're sad to do their living for some other kind of thrill. Smash your bottle on the gravestone and live while you can. That homeless brother is my friend. Somewhere there was a woman, somewhere there was a child, somewhere there was a cottage where the marigolds grew wild. But somewhere's just like nowhere when you leave it for a while. You'll find the brokenhearted when you're traveling jungle style. Down the bowels of a broken land where numbers live like men, where those who keep their senses have them taken back again, where the nightstick cracks with crazy rage, where madmen don't pretend. Wealth has no beginning and poverty no end. Smash your bottle on the gravestone and live while you can. That homeless brother is my friend. The ghosts of highway royalty have vanished in the night. The Whitman wanderer walking toward a glowing inner light. The children have grown older and the cops have gripped us tight. There's no spot round the melting pot for free men in their flight. And you who live on promises and prosper as you please, the victim of your riches often dies of your disease. He can't hear the factory whistle, just the lonesome freight trains wheeze. He's living on good fortune, he ain't dying on his knees. Smash your bottle on the gravestone and live while you can. That homeless brother is my friend. That homeless brother is my friend.
Thanks for being
on. It's a pleasure.
Good luck to us. Good luck to us. The next edition of Good Night America in exactly 2 weeks is a very special one. It's called Opening Night, and it's our salute to Broadway, the Great White Way. Our guests will include Carol Channing, Marlo Thomas, Ben Vereen, the Andrew Sisters, Peter Cook, and Dudley Moore. That's in 2 weeks. Don't miss it. Okay, hit our goodbye.
Now we're going to hear a fantastic bass part. Right now. Here you go. Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go.
Do, 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 do.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go.
Do, 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 do.
I hate to leave you, but I really must say.
Yeah.
Good night, sweetheart.
Do, 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 do.
You know what you sing? Good night, sweetheart.
Peace, my friends.
Well,
I love you all. Good night, America.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time.
Hello.
To go.